Namaste. We learned about the element of water or Jala Mahabhuta in our previous video. We understood the various aspects and attributes of Jala and also the role it plays in this universe. In this video, we will try to understand the Sthulatama Mahabhuta or the grossest of the five elements, Prithvi or the element of earth, and analyze its various attributes. This video will be a sequel to the previous four videos in this series, and hence it is recommended to watch those videos first to get a better grip on the concepts explained in this video. Simply Ayurveda is an initiative to explore and share the concepts of the vast science of Ayurveda in an easy manner. Consider subscribing to our channel. Adhyaha Prithvi. Prithvi is produced when the bonds holding the previous Mahabhuta, which is Jala, starts becoming stronger. Hence, Jala loses its prime character of flexibility. The dense cohesive bonds releases energy which generates mass, and this mass is what we call the Prithvi Mahabhuta. In simpler terms, Prithvi is the mass generated due to the energy itself, and Prithvi need not represent gross matter as a whole. The dynamics of Prithvi Mahabhuta can be understood by considering its gunas and karmas. The mass or Guru Guna can be understood easily with the following example. Consider that you overeat. This distends the stomach because food is densely packed inside, and this leaves no room for any movements. This is where the sense of heaviness or Gaurava comes from. Due to the laws of nature, whatever is more Guru moves down. We can now correlate and understand why after the heavy meal you feel tired and lethargic. This also corresponds with Tamo Bahulam Prithvi, that is, Prithvi Bhuta is predominant of Tamo Guna. Stula Guna or grossness is caused due to the close approximation of particles due to the bonds becoming stronger. This leads to the creation of visible matter. Tiraguna is similar, where due to the close proximity of the particles by virtue of their strong bonds, reduces the space between the particles, holding the material in a relatively stable state. This Tiratva attained is what which complements with Gurutva. Gandhaguna is the cardinal attribute of Prithvi Mahabhuta. How can we analyze this? There are two widely accepted mechanisms for smell perception called the vibrational theory and the docking theory. We are not going to explain it in deep, but the fundamental approach is that smell characterization is due to the interaction between the molecules and the protein odorant receptors present in the nasal epithelium. We already explained that mass is generated by virtue of bonds. This mass carrying data about the substance is what is relayed as an electric signal to the brain and perceived as smell. Hence, we can conclude that Prithvi Mahabhuta is responsible for Gandhagrahana. The other two karmas of Prithvi Mahabhuta are Sanghata, which represents compactness, and Upachaya, which represents accumulation or nourishment, again due to these interactions. Let us try to understand the explanation given in Tarka Sangraha. Tatra Gandhavati Prithvi, Sa Dvividaha, Nitya Anitya Cha, Nitya Paramanu Rupa, Anitya Karya Rupa, Sa Punastrividha, Sharire Indre Vishe Bhedat, Shariram Asmadadinam, Indriyam Gandhagrahakam Granam Nasagravarti, Vishayo Mrit Pashanadihi. Prithvi is that which is qualified by smell. It exists in two states, the eternal or nitya state having Paramanu Rupa and the perishable or anitya state which is the Karya Rupa. The Karya Rupa exists in three forms. Parthiva Sharira is told to be the physical body of humans and other organisms. The Indriya corresponding to Prithvi is Ghranendriya or the olfactory faculty which is present at the nasal epithelium. The vishayas or objects include all the solid earthly objects like soil, stones, etc. We completed the literary portion of Prithvi Mahabhuta, but to understand it better, let us consider some statements regarding mass. This is again correlated with how heaviness is felt when the stomach stretches due to overeating. Gurutva here is a physical resistance offered to the force which is stretching caused by excess food. This explains why tamasic people lie in ignorance due to their refusal to change. This explains why Guru is a guna of Prithvi and Gurutva is the karma. We can understand the above statement based on our previous explanations on how bonds create mass. From the view of Chikitsa, we know that most Kaphaja conditions are best treated with Vamana. How does Vamana act in Kaphaja diseases? We know that Kaphadosha is Prithvi Pradhana. The Gurutva and Mandatva caused by Kapha can be understood as due to the increased bonding and compactness. We know that due to the tightly packed space, normal vibrations are hampered. This is how normal functions of the body are disturbed. What Vamana does is generate an upheaval which regenerates Kha or proper space and allows proper Chalatvam to resume. In simpler terms, the Vishesha Guna of Prithvi are imposed. The Urdhva Marga Dosha Nirharana of Vamana also act against the Adhogami Guru Guna of Prithvi. Tarjanadikrama, explained in Unmada Chikitsa, also does similar action of displacing the bonds by provoking Vata. This breaks up the Manodoshas and brings back the normal functioning of the Manas. Let us now look into how the metal gold and Prithvi Mahabhuta are related. We all have learned the chemical properties of gold in our school days. Gold is a stable species and has the highest electron affinity of any metal. It is very much unreactive and has a very long shelf life because it is not attacked by acids, air or oxygen. It is a dense metal. All these data help us correlate gold with the gunas of Prithvi Bhuta. We can understand why gold is worn as an ornament to induce a state of sattva or stability. Even internally, it acts as a stabilizer of electron movement and slows down the rate of metabolism within the cells. Gold also increases ojas as it maintains the structural integrity of molecules and slows down the rate of degeneration. Basically, gold maintains youthfulness. We shall now discuss some additional facts about Prithvi Mahabhuta. Among the platonic solids, the earth element is represented by the cube. This mudra is used to rever the Prithvi Mahabhuta in Indian culture. We have reached the end of this video and also the end of the Mahabhuta series. Thank you for watching. If you like this video, hit the like button and comment your opinions. Share with your friends and consider subscribing to our channel. Follow us on Instagram and Facebook for more updates.